Hey there, friends. It's me again, Carpo, your local carpenter slash family man slash, oh God, name it. I mean, I like to do just about everything, but carpentry is my chosen field, or rather the field that chose me. And as I got to work this morning, I started thinking about just how much work it is to learn any trade, to learn any job, to especially to gain the tools necessary to do anything. And this isn't just what we do for a living, this is what we do for life, right? And I like to compare things metaphorically, obviously. So I was thinking about all the different tools required and how it made me think there was a time in history when carpenters had a hammer, a square, a compass, you know, had to make their own nails or else buy, you know, cut nails. But today things are much more complicated in the field. We've made things much more complicated in everything. I mean, just look at the tools necessary to do a basic job of what I do. This is like half of what I have to carry. You know, several different types of chisels, screwdrivers, a bag of various screw guns, nails, you know, sawzall, all these things. Are they all necessary? Do I really need three drills? No, but it's a lot faster and easier if I have all three of them. So I can put on different bits and whatnot. I've got my router box, my routers, my nail guns. And then, you know, out here, naturally, you've got to have a table saw, chop saw, air compressor. Here's my crappy little 3 gallon thing that I bought, because it works and it suits its purpose. But I've been doing carpentry for about 20 years, something like that. And this house I'm working on right now is a client that, he's a nice guy, you know, he works in the tech industry and he, you know, has a nice little place here and he wants to make it just, you know, the way he likes it. So we put in this deck out here and tore out the window that was in the bedroom and then put in a double door, which still needs to be painted. Replaced this window, those windows, the door here. He put in this new awning that opens up. It's got like a remote control. And then there used to be a door right here, just an exterior door. I tore it out and put in this rolling garage door because he works on bicycles. So he doesn't just work on bicycles. He's got, you know, bikes that are worth probably 4 or 5 times more than my car. And he's got his hobby. He's got his things that he does. And just thinking about the differences in the career paths that we have and the interests that we have, yet we're human beings, so we're similar. And so what he wanted me to do in here was, and this is kind of the crux of my discussion, that all the different tools it takes, there's still one tool that is the most difficult to navigate, and that's the tool of the mind, to know how to apply it to the things that we do. To think things through and know that there are so many different ways to do things. We've pretty much remodeled this whole house. This used to be a garage, but it's been now, the garage is on the other side of that wall. This has been converted into where we put flooring in, you know, new drywall, air conditioner, all that. Then like the bathroom in here, put in a new shower tile. This is all completely redone. A sauna over here. Then I put in a couple of nice little steps in here leading up into the house. We've done everything. This kitchen right here was remodeled. It was pretty much new, and then it was remodeled, and then he didn't like it, I guess, so because he wanted to choose a different tile, so we redid it again. And everything in here is pretty much redone. I have to take these oak pieces here and sand them down and then cut them to fit the mantle, as well as these post wraps over here. Put in a new front door. We tiled the fireplace here. And you know, it's a little bit of this, a little bit of that. A full remodel in there. Full bathroom remodel here. So I've been here working on this job for about 6 to 7 months now. So I guess it's been over eight months. It's pretty much the farthest job from my house. So every morning I have to drive like 45 minutes to get here and an hour to get home. Definitely wears on me. He's out of town right now. It's Labor Day weekend. I probably should be too, but I don't know. I guess sitting here, I just wanted to, I guess partially, maybe I just wanted to show off the work that we've been doing. I guess that I've been doing for the most part. Now, this final bedroom, this is gonna be the exercise slash bicycle room. As you can see, we've put up all this paneling here. It goes all the way across. We were one piece short, but this wall right here, you can see the little crack along there. That's because I have made a secret door handle, which allows us to open a door up into the garage. And he saw this on YouTube, so he wanted me to replicate it. Now, I just had to use my best brain power to figure out how to do it exactly, because we did the exact same thing over here. This door was put in, it's a large door, you can't tell, but the whole thing was built, and then these guys came and put this garage door in, and the door would no longer open. So I had to taper the corner and cut the whole corner of the thing off. And this one also has a hidden handle. And it opens up like that. And you can see then it barely clears the garage door. And it's gonna be like the bike closet. So it's got a big wheel holding it up and whatnot. What I did here was I used a deadbolt. Standard deadbolt, recessed it in. And then on the other side where the little turn thing is, I embedded it in the edge of this. And I think it's pretty sweet, personally. But you know, that's just me. So anyway, he likes it. That's all that matters. So now we were trying to figure out what to do with trim, so I talked him into making black trim, which is going to go all along the bottom and the top. And as I'm working on this, I sometimes get flustered. I get here in the morning and I think, where do I start? You know, how do I tackle this job? Because I have to figure it out. I have to figure out how to do the things. I have to figure out, you know, what's the best method for doing it. And there are suggestions by the client, by the boss, by the other workers of how they would do it. But ultimately, it's up to me to decide the best approach for me and my own skills. And I guess that just goes with everything in life, you know. One of the hardest things of being younger and growing up is not the point where you have to start thinking, well, I should say it is probably the part where you have to start thinking for yourself, because you realize that everybody else has suggestions, but very rarely do those suggestions give you the best, I guess, the best method for approaching something in a way that you feel like you can get it done properly. And especially the different skill levels. And this is, I guess you could say, this would be the way I view everything. The approach to navigating a conversation with somebody. The approach to having, you know, a deep, heartfelt conversation with someone you love. The approach to getting angry and violent with somebody that's, you know, threatening you. The different tools that we've got, gathered along our years to try to handle each situation in a very efficient manner. It's not always possible. Sometimes we're introduced to something new that we haven't seen before. You know, maybe we've never had any real conflict in our lives. I think most people have. But we're constantly wrestling with different ways to do things, better ways to do things, trying to figure out what works for us. And there are so many people out there who you would call followers, I guess. Those who, you know, just follow along with everybody else does. And I know a lot of people out there think that they're independent. We all want to be independent, but the truth is we need each other. We need each other's ideas. Just in the video I made the other day about gurus, and a couple people mentioned that they are their own guru. And that's something I completely agree with. But in order to even understand what the term guru means, we have to first identify what we know about gurus. And we don't even know if we're the best advice for ourselves if we haven't listened to other people. So it's a matter of going through the motions, just like being a carpenter, watching somebody do something. There's no way I could jump in and say, I just do carpentry my way. First, I have to see people do things their way. And that's how we can get a better assessment, become more worldly, and start to see a different method of doing things. And I think a major component is finding the confidence to believe that we can do things differently and that we can successfully do things differently. Thinking outside the box, you know, so many years, I've spent trying to figure this thing called life out and trying to live it at the same time. You know, the hard problem of consciousness, as they call it, is not being able to study consciousness because you're conscious, and it's the same way of not being able to really process the best life because you're trying to live it at the same time. I feel very fortunate and grateful. I know a lot of folks out there wish that things were different for them, or especially one of the worst things we can do is regret the past. And personally, I think that everything that's happened to us is crucial to building our character and determining who we are. It doesn't mean that they're all good things, but we can definitely avoid the negative next time if we know what to look out for. And ultimately, by the time we think we start having things figured out, we're already getting old, you know, and that's okay. There's wisdom in that. And just realizing and embracing that, you know, there's no way to know what an elderly person is thinking when you're 16 years old, right? That's why I respect my elders, respect the old man walking down the street with a cane, probably has, you know, decades of wisdom, but that's not always the case. Sometimes the guy knows nothing. There are people who have spent their lives not listening to anyone else or taking anyone's advice or even being curious about why people think the way they think. And that's, I think, it's a travesty for the individual. Because regardless of what I believe religiously or spiritually about this life, I think that our ultimate goal is to become as integrated into this world as we can. Be able to interact with the greatest amount of people, be able to keep the greatest amount of positivity while still allowing ourselves to have negative emotions and to let them flow through us. So, just figuring out the tools for the job, I guess. Anyhow, that's my rant for the morning. I guess I better get back to work now because I got a lot of trim to put up. I've got to repaint all these black pieces and get them in there. And now that I've started and I got first through the first 20 rough minutes, I can push forward. It's like they say, you just got to start. No, you just got to start. So, bye now. I'll see y'all next time. Be well. Much love.